Public opinion polls show we live in a deeply divided country, particularly when it comes to politics. It's been 4 months since the election and just a few weeks into the new Trump administration. So how are voters responding? The NewsHour's William Brangham is just back from a reporting trip to Texas. He's here with me now. So what exactly did you set out to do?
We wanted to talk to voters on both sides of the political spectrum. So we were in Texas, we went to two very different places, and I asked people basically four, five, six questions, identical questions in both places. And as you'll see, it's as if voters are living in two completely different worlds. Let's take a look.
Belleville, Texas is a small rural town an hour's drive from Houston. Its streets are lined with single-family homes and locally owned shops. But a recently renamed restaurant in town has become something of an attraction, the Trump Cafe.
So you changed the name to Trump Cafe 2 weeks before the election?
Before, yes, sir.
What if Trump hadn't won the election?
We don't, you know, actually we pray for God to, he wins. I'm so glad he wins. I'm so glad, you know.
Actually, so if Hillary Clinton had won, would this be Clinton Cafe?
No, I will move back home.
Sue Hawa owns the place with her husband. Trump memorabilia is everywhere. The big seller on the menu is the Trump burger, onion ring, barbecue sauce, bacon, topped with an American flag. As you might imagine, the Trump Cafe is full of Trump supporters. 80% of the county here voted for the president.
How was election night for you?
Oh, it was great. Man, I was on cloud nine. I was a Trump guy from day one.
Is that right? Day one.
Yeah, from day one. As soon as he said it, I was like, you know, we need something other than a politician.
I was so excited when he won because, you know, I just believed in everything that he says. And, you know, we were so ready for a change. And he listened to the people.
100 miles west and a political world apart is Austin, the state capital, a liberal outpost in this red state. We visited what's perhaps Austin's version of the Trump Cafe, the Bolden Creek Cafe, a vegetarian place in South Austin. Two-thirds of the county here voted for Hillary Clinton. Chesley Allen is the general manager.
It's kind of the nexus or the heart of what people think of when they think of Austin. It's the offbeat, funky, keep Austin weird, that sort of thing.
That's where we are.
That's where you are.
The day after President Trump's inauguration, the cafe donated profits to the ACLU, the Southern Poverty Law Center, and Planned Parenthood.
Because I'm pretty sure that I fit almost every demographic that's going to be ruined by this administration, that I feel like I have to speak out.
What was election night like for you?
Brutal, devastating, heartbreaking.
If I were to have a nightmare that night, then my nightmare would be a reality, because I definitely didn't want Trump to win.
My big fear with him is that he's coming out fast and hard with a lot of big stuff, but I really truly believe that he's just trying to tire out his opposition.
To spend a few hours in these two places, talking to people on either side of the political divide, is to see just how deep the chasm is in our politics.
What have you made of his cabinet picks so far?
I love every one of them. I love Betsy DeVos. I love her. I hope she does something about education. I love Sessions, Jeff Sessions. He is not a racist. This is ridiculous.
I don't know how he could have picked more unqualified people to run things like the, you know, Education Department or Rick Perry for energy. It's a direct mirror of how much of a role money plays in politics.
The politics of the team running the White House, including Steve Bannon, former chairman of Breitbart News, has been a source of controversy.
There's been a lot of questions raised recently about Steve Bannon. What's your
thought? I love Steve Bannon. I think he's great. He says what he means what he says, and that's why they don't like him. People who are just namby-pamby little me, they don't like people who are outspoken.
You have any thoughts on Steve Bannon?
Yes, he's the devil incarnate.
The devil incarnate.
Yes. He got the man elected, and so I guess he's got a payback, so he made him some advisor. But everything he stands for, I do not, so.
I have a lot of Muslim friends and friends who are also people of color, and so it's just very disturbing to me how it could have progressed to such a state.
Patrons of these two places are also split on the news they trust.
What are your three or four main sources of news?
I would say The Guardian, CNN, and ironically, well, not ironically, like PBS and NPR. So I listen to NPR every morning.
I think it's great that he's on Twitter, because now, you know, we know what he's thinking.
No filter there.
Yeah, there's no filter.
It's pretty much a bet that a mainline journalist is going to be not a conservative, be more in the school of being progressive and everything.
Where are the main sources of, when you want to find out what's going on?
Fox
News.
I will not look at CNN. I get ill.
Straight up Fox News viewer.
Yes.
I'll tell you what I did. I have a brother that watches Fox News constantly. And it's on 24 hours a day, I think, at his house. They came here to Austin to visit me over Christmas. And the room he was staying in has a TV. And on the cable box, I blocked that station.
I have a sister who can't stand the guy. And, you know, we still talk, but I try not to talk politics with her.
She's still your sister, though.
Yeah, she's still my sister. I mean, she's always going to be my sister.
We just don't discuss it. We don't get into politics.
You know each other's views, and you don't talk about it.
I respect their views, and we just don't talk politics.
The couple who runs the Trump Cafe say there's a reason they're open to all diners. Their own story seems to cross political divides.
So you're a Palestinian Muslim couple that owns a cafe in Texas named the Trump Cafe. You understand how some people might think, that sounds like a bizarre combination.
I like my president. Actually, I like him because he's a businessman. He knows how to do business, you know. And actually, what he tried to do, it's excellent.
Now, do you let Democrats eat here?
You know, welcome, you know, welcome to everyone likes to come inside my restaurant, you know.
Right.
My door open for everybody. You know, public and democratic, same, you know.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm William Brangham.